Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update includes a little bit of everything, although I will mainly be focusing on a new report about the surprise of the year or what might develop into the first eruption in West Iceland since our country was settled 1100 years ago. But it's a good idea to start on the Reykjanes Peninsula, where the magma inflow into this magma chamber by Svartsengi is still around 50% more than we've got used to after prior eruptions. And in addition to that, we have this new magma dike at this new location that is not in our favor, and it just sent us a magnitude 3 earthquake, so it's not quite cold yet. And the 48-hour earthquake map, it shows the complete peninsula literally split apart with this magma dike that is over 20 kilometers long now. And I still stand by what I said just a few weeks ago. All bets are off. We have no clue about where this is taking us. But I'm not diving very deep now. I have a separate video in the making where I'm looking at the big picture, but it's best to wait a few days more. And it's not as we lack subjects elsewhere. Like, we just got another magnitude 3 plus in Bárðarbunga volcano, and the green stars on the map indicating magnitude 3 plus, they are getting more and more frequent around there as the magma chamber is filling up gradually. Will the next eruption make it through the ice? Or will we get another subsurface magma dike that opens just somewhere, maybe hitting groundwater on the way, and come up with something like this? That is still unclear. However, according to the statistics, it should take this magma chamber more time to fill up, and the next door volcano Grímsvötn might be first to erupt, because it often looks from the seismometers as Bárðarbunga is putting pressure on the other systems. So if we would get a moderate Grímsvötn eruption, that might release some of the pressure there. But those systems are closely related, although it hasn't been explained fully how. And as we check out Askja volcano, the land uplift curve has flattened out a bit, but earthquakes are detected there every day. And if we follow the fracture swarm, that's where we have the Tjörnes fracture zone, and it's looking more and more suspicious. And last week I noticed earthquakes at the worst location possible, on the fault that runs through the village Húsavík and produces some of the strongest earthquakes here in Iceland. So it's always bad news when earthquakes start hitting there, or this part of this complex system, and it was in this bay where the ocean retreated during the last big one, and as it returned in the form of a flood, fishermen drowned. And this is where the fault comes up, just by the town. And as you look along it, we see a story about tectonic forces. But as I've mentioned numerous times, the seismic activity comes in like waves. And overall, I'm seeing lots of activity under my island now. Magnitude 3 plus earthquakes at 4 locations in the last 3 days. And that is quite a lot. And last week, we just got a new report about the suspicious earthquakes in West Iceland. And scientists believe that we have magma on the move there. And as for the statistics, the most likely scenario is of course that this will fade out. But only a few days after the report got released, we got a magnitude 3.7 earthquake there. And that is the strongest earthquake there so far. Strong enough to make the author of the report step forward again, and he told us about increased probability of an eruption, since this new earthquake was some kind of game changer, as he looked at this. But this report was, however, quite simple to read, even for me, and our scientists, they need more equipment there, they need more seismometers and more GPS stations, and they need also to do more studies on the lava fields associated with this system. And this system is actually not on the plate boundaries. It's been totally inactive. So until now, this has not been a priority to dive deep into it. And the youngest lava is around 1100 years old. So we don't have as much data from here as we have from the Reykjanes Peninsula. But in West Iceland, the geology book that Mother Earth left us with, lying on the ground, it's just way smaller. It's also older and scattered all over the place. So scientists don't have much to work with there, actually. And what they expect is a relatively small eruption that won't leave us with much lava or just a few square kilometers of land that would undergo some serious changes. And that is the only logical assumption they can get based on evidence from past eruptions. And they expect the eruption location to be close to this 15 square kilometer radius where the earthquakes takes place now, unless the magma finds a good fracture to run through. And what came as a bit of a surprise in this report was the timing, or how long time this takes to develop into an eruption. I was somehow expecting weeks or months, but the author of the report mentioned the 1973 eruption specifically. That is the eruption that occurred in the Westman Islands, and it took the magma only 30 hours to shoot up to the islands from the mantle. So that is one of the possible scenarios according to scientists now. And that made me think about the last earthquake swarm after the magnitude 3.7. Many of the earthquakes were detected at less depth than usual. It doesn't have to be magma on the move, of course. But I noticed that the accuracy of the earthquakes, that is usually around 99% on the Reykjanes Peninsula, was way less there. And that has to do with the lack of seismometers. So I had a feeling that Icelandic geologists are trying to get some budget for tools because it is highly important that you know in time if and when this is coming up because we have farmlands all around. So what the scientists are doing now is to prepare us for rather fast takeoff if this will develop like that, although it is still possible that this will fade out. But this is, however, quite enough reason for me to do some filming around there, more than I've done so far. Most of the local footage I have is from the valley Hítardalur, but the earthquake epicenter is in the next valley beside it. I've been driving close by several times recently due to all my trips to the south to capture the smallest eruption in the history of Iceland. But as for the visibility, I've not been lucky while driving by. And since I don't expect anything to happen there in a matter of weeks, I am not going to get too stressed over the lack of footage from the exact earthquake location. But as soon as we get some colors in the ground, I know I won't be able to hold back. And I might even shoot some footage from a car as well, like I have from the complete valley Hítardalur, and I'm linking to that video. And as for the rest of the system, it has been on my filming list for some time, and since I was mentioning footage shot from a car, I have to remind you about new uploads, but this is what you will see on the channel now. When I'm not doing my volcano updates, the tourist section will be very busy, but I do however suspect that the next volcano update isn't far away. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.